Basically, walking football, it's just it's a slower version, a lower impact game of football. So it's basically adapted rules, things like three-touch limit, as you'll see behind me, no running. So Walking Football Scotland, the information we get from them is that you must have one foot on the ground at all times, and that means you're not running. Things like, just to make it a bit safer as well, like especially here at Pro Soccer, you're not allowed to tackle into the boards, no tackling from behind, just things like that to make it generally safer for the guys as well.
Walking football has been a fantastic opportunity for me and most over 50s now. It's primarily over 50, but different age groups apply. But it's been something, Scottish FA talk about the football for life, the complete circle, and I would think even here at the Academy, the Ayr United Football Academy, we spoke about that first. But the older generation were left. You could do line dancing, not that I'm against line dancing, but it wasn't for me. The bingo, the bridge clubs, you know, things that a lot of the people just wouldn't get active. So walking football became that activity, getting people active, getting them engaged again or re-engaged in exercise. And that's what walking football brought to as older generation, the forgotten generation. Walking Football Scotland is a charity and was set up in December. It came through the participant, it's a participant-led organisation, and I was elected to be chairman of Walking Football in Scotland. So that we now have started in 2012. It was Paths for All charity, and Age Scotland had started it off in Midlothian, and it grew from there. And 2015 was the first national competition, and we have differences with competition and the health benefits. So national competition started 2015. I think there was 14 teams took part. This Saturday, 23rd of June, there were almost 600 people taking part, participating in Glasgow Green in Glasgow. So it's huge. We're from Walking Football Scotland, has members from the Shetlands, Orkney to Scottish borders. So there's over 120, 130 sessions. There's 2,000 regular participants playing walking football. So there's more than that. And we have 82 groups across Scotland. So we're getting there.
So it kind of came from funding from the SFA that we got to try and start a walking football centre in here. We started it off and we were getting threes and fours, and we built it up to kind of 8 to 10 people playing five a side. And we kind of noticed that the guys that were playing were really enjoying it. They were getting loads of health benefits as well, but they were also getting a social side of it. The guys were turning up 15 minutes early for a wee chat while they were warming up, and they were staying after. Some of them were going for teas and coffees after it, the kind of social aspect as well. So we kind of noticed that it was a really good programme. So then we managed to get funding from the Scottish Football Partnership that allowed us to run the centre for a full year for free, and it also allowed us to kind of open up more centres as well. And we just kind of noticed that there was a gap in our provision for the academy, because when we looked at our programmes, it was heavily dominated by the kind of youth setup and a lot of stuff for kids, but we had very little stuff for kind of adults, especially at the over 50 age. So it allowed us to kind of try and build that up as well. Now we're up to 6 different centres. So we cover Truro, Prestwick, we've got 2 in Ayr, we've got 1 in Maybole and 1 in Girvan. And within these centres, it's a lot of local people. The 2 in Ayr, we tend to get people from all over South Ayrshire come to it, but the ones in Prestwick and especially Truro, Maybole and Girvan, it's all members from the local community, and especially Maybole and Girvan, it's very rural communities as well. So it's really important that the centre kind of acts as a kind of hub for these guys to kind of come down and meet, and then obviously get the social and the health benefits that we were talking about. Very successful. As I say, we started off at the Citadel in Ayr with 8 players playing 4 a side. Now we've built it up to 6 different centres throughout South Ayrshire. We cover the kind of whole main towns in South Ayrshire, and we're up to about 80 players a week playing. We're now affiliated to Walking Football Scotland, who we attended their tournament on Saturday, which was the Scottish Cup at Glasgow Green. We've also had our own tournament here at Pro Soccer, so we had over 120 guys over the age of 50 down here playing. We've had guys go to Portugal and Spain to represent Ayr in tournaments. And we've also had a group of guys go down and represent Scotland at the over 65s Walking Football World Cup. So it was 6 guys from Ayr and three from Hartlepool and Lothian walking football programme. And they went down there and won the World Walking Football World Cup down in Bristol last month. So it's been, for us, it's been really successful. And if you look at our participants, we've got people who are recovering from brain tumours. We have people who are recovering from heart problems, just other kind of general health problems. We've got people that have had mental health issues that have kind of came down and really got a lot of benefit out of the programme. Just in terms of coming down and just getting to play football again that they haven't played for years and just kind of socialising with a group of guys again. So it's been really, really positive. And for us looking forward, again, we're looking to... I see potential for Walton Football to expand even further with the interest we're getting. Big one for me is to try and get more women involved. We are trying hard to set up a women's centre as well, because it isn't just for guys, it's for male and female. And there is a few other all-female centres throughout Scotland, so we are looking to try and get one started in here.
Life-changing. I've had two heart attacks, seven stents in my heart, and at one time struggled to go up the stairs. So my wife had links with the Ayr United Football Academy and got me roped in. And again, we talked about perception. The perception of walking football is old men walking about, and it's not that. And you can see here today that it's not that, that the guys are active. They're breaking sweat out there.
Thoroughly enjoy it. The reason being, my recent history was physical wise. I've got arthritis and I was basically, my muscles were turning to seed and they weren't supporting my joints. So I get fed up walking the dog. So somebody suggested I go to walking football. And it's been a great bonus to me physically, but also mentally, because I get a buzz each and every day that I'm going to play football. The social side of things is fantastic. Very, very friendly bunch of chaps in this area. Played in a few tournaments, and even the tournaments who are very competitive, the chaps who other teams are very nice guys, you know. I'm thoroughly pleased that I joined it, and I recommend it to anybody who's got an interest in football, no matter what level they feel that they're at. You know.
Yeah, well, I moved into Ayr 3 years ago. I was looking for something to do, a hobby. I loved football, so I came along to watch the guys at Pro Soccer. Saw them, thought, good bunch of blokes, good way to socialise and make new friends. So, fantastic. So, since then, I've been playing twice a week, and playing in tournaments as well. So like on Saturday I was in the Scottish Cup final team, got beaten in penalties, so pretty depressed about it, really down. Thought, right, I've got to get back and play again, so I've turned up Monday lunchtime to have a game again, which is brilliant. Normally I play Monday evenings in Maybole at Carrick Academy, Fridays at Prestwick, but the good thing is we've got now six centres, so if you miss one or two, you can always pick something up later on the week.